Hello children, hope you studied last day's portions. What we studied last 2 days? In the first class, we discussed the meaning of federalism, difference between unitary and federal form of country, key features of federalism, and 2 kinds of federations. And in the second class, we studied what makes India a federal country. Today we are going to study how is federalism practiced. How is federalism practiced? That is today's topic. The real success of federalism in India can be attributed to the nature of democratic politics in our country. This ensured that the spirit of federalism, respect for diversity. India is the best example for unity in diversity. The way we are respecting diversity is a very important part for the success of federalism. Let us look at some of the major ways in which this happened. First, we can take linguistic state. Linguistic states mean formation of states based on language. The creation of linguistic states was the first and a major test for democratic politics in our country. After independence, states were created based on language. Why this was done? What was the reason? This was done to ensure that people who spoke the same language lived in the same state. What are the merits of formation of states based on language? 2 merits are there. One is, this made the country more united. It has also made administration easier. The merits of formation of states based on language. First one, this made the country more united and it has also made administration easier. Some states in our country were not created on the basis of language, but to recognize differences based on culture, ethnicity or geography. Examples are Nagaland, Uttarakhand, and Jharkhand. Name any 2 states formed on the basis of culture, ethnicity or geography. One of the board question. Answer, Nagaland, Uttarakhand and Jharkhand. So what we studied? Linguistic states. Linguistic state means formation of states based on language. After independence, states were created based on languages. The creation of linguistic state was the first and a major test for democratic politics in our country. Now we can move to the second one, that is language policy. In India, no language has the status of national language. Besides Hindi, there are 21 other languages recognized as scheduled languages by the Indian Constitution, which can be used by the state as an official language also. What do you mean by scheduled language? Scheduled language means in India, 22 languages are included in the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution and therefore called scheduled languages. There are 12 schedules in Indian Constitution. Among this, 8th schedule dealt with language policy. Total how many schedules are there in Indian Constitution? 12 schedules. Among these, 8th schedule dealt with language policy. Some tribal languages also included in the 8th schedule of Indian Constitution. Bodo, Dogri, Santali, Maithili, etc. These are some examples of tribal languages. What is the merit of this language policy? This flexible language policy helped in strengthening federal structure. So 2 points we discussed. One is linguistic states. You know, after independence, states were created on the basis of language. Second one we discussed, that is language policy. No language has the status of national language. 22 languages are recognized as scheduled languages. third one is center-state relations. Before discussing center-state relation, we can divide this into two periods. First one, center-state relation before 1990 and center-state relation after 1990. First one, center-state relation before 1990. For a long time, the same party ruled both at the center and in most of the states. This means that there were very few problems with the center and the state governments when the ruling party at the state level was different. For example, center was ruled by International Congress and state was ruled by Communist Party of India, Marxist. Then parties that ruled at the center tried to suppress the power of the states. This undermines the spirit of federalism. This was the situation of India before 1990. Once again, I will repeat. For a long time, the same party ruled both at the center and in most of the states. So, no issues were there. When the ruling party at the state level was different, then the party that ruled at the center tried to suppress the power of the states. That undermined the spirit of federalism. What was the change after 1990? All these changed after 1990. This period saw the rise of regional political parties in many states of the country and the era of coalition government at the center. What do you mean by coalition government? A government formed by joining more than two political parties. Since no single party got a clear majority in the Lok Sabha, the major political parties were forced to join hand with the regional parties to form government at the center. This led to a new culture of power sharing and respect for the autonomy of state governments. So what is the last point we discussed? Center-state relation. There we discussed center-state relation before 1990 and center-state relation after 1990. Center-state relation before 1990, both the center and state, that means for a long time the same party ruled both at the center and in most of the states. This means that there were fewer problems with the center and state governments. When the ruling party at the state level was different, then the party ruled at the center tried to suppress the power of the state. That undermined the spirit of federalism. But after 1990, all these changed. A new era developed. That is an era of coalition government at the center. No single party got a clear majority in Lok Sabha. Then the major political parties were formed to join hand with regional parties to form government at the center. The merit of this is, this led to a new culture of power sharing and respect for the autonomy of state governments. What we studied today, how is federalism practiced? We studied three main points. First one, linguistic states. Second one, language policy. And third one, center-state relations. Next, we can move to homework questions. First one, the creation of linguistic states was the first and a major test for democratic politics in our country. Elaborate this statement. Very important question. So you can write, after independence, states were created based on language. Why this was done? Because to ensure that people who spoke the same language lived in the same state itself. The merit of the formation of state based on language. The first one, this made the country more united. It has also made administration easier. This much you want to write in that question. Explain the language policy of India. There you can write, in India, no language has the status of national language. Besides Hindi, there are 21 other languages recognized as scheduled language by the constitution, which can be used by the state as an official language also. The merit of the language policy is, this flexible language policy helped in strengthening federal structure. Then the last question is, write the difference between the center-state relations before and after 1990. So first you want to write the center-state relation before 1990, then you want to write center-state relationship after 1990. Today we can conclude here. We can meet again tomorrow.